What's up guys, Sal here. So Google has decided to make some major changes to how Android works in the EU after the 5 billion antitrust fine levied against it by the European Commission earlier this year. If you don't know what I'm talking about, let me explain you in brief what exactly happened. The European Commission fined $5 billion to Google because Google required Android vendors to follow a certain set of rules. That includes pre-installing a set of their apps like Google Chrome and Google Search Engine. Kinda like when they fined Microsoft for pre-installing Internet Explorer years ago. Google responded by saying the included apps are their source of income, which they need to cover services like Play Store and Google Maps that also comes in the package. Google said, they give out Android for free, so to fund the development and free distribution of Android, they have to pre-install these apps. Google appealed this fine, but that has been declined by the European Commission. So now what happened is, Google agreed to the EU and decided to unbundle Search and Chrome from the rest of the Google apps. So now OEMs will have the option to skip Chrome and Search, but now Google is essentially saying, okay, if you don't pre-install Chrome and Search and make it default, then you have to pay me up to $40 per device to use our rest of the Google apps like YouTube, Gmail, and etc. So now what I think is gonna happen is companies like Microsoft will pay OEMs to set Microsoft Edge as the default browser and Bing as the default search engine and use the Google Play Store alongside with it. Prior to this, Microsoft could only have their apps pre-installed, not set as default. Just being pre-installed as the default provides an enormous boost to market share. Bing exists and makes money solely based on being the default search engine on Windows-powered devices. And the kicker here is that their most popular searches are various spellings of Google. They make money off of that. Google is willing to spend $12 billion to be Apple's default search provider in 2019 because they're gonna make more than that back in ad revenue. I just think people are underestimating the amount of money to be made here. Another big change that European Commission forced Google to make is allow the forked version of Android, like Amazon's Fire OS. Earlier, what used to happen is, if OEMs make a forked version of Android, Google wouldn't let them use Play Store and other Google apps. Before, Google said that if you produce any phone that uses Android but doesn't use Google apps, you're blacklisted for life as a manufacturer from using any Google apps ever again. So companies like Samsung could never produce an Android phone that doesn't have Google apps on it. But with EU's ruling, Google has to allow the Play Store on the forked Android. All the devices that sell in China are forked version of Android, so it's possible we could see Chinese OEMs like Xiaomi, Huawei and more launch Google free devices in the EU. Now, a mix of forked Android and Google Android will be allowed, which is gonna affect Google's revenue a lot. I think a lot of people underestimate just how potentially big this is. We might not see the changes right away, but 5 years down the line, yes for sure. I can't wait to see what happens. Perhaps all the Android partners will pay this licensing fee, perhaps few will, and if they don't, maybe Google experiences zero drop-off in use of its smartphone apps and technologies. Or maybe Microsoft gets aggressive about dangling cash at Android device makers who are happy to cash in by pushing alternatives to Google Search on the smartphone buying masses. We also may see many more experiments with Android devices that have few hints of Google. I hope we do, but I suspect we won't now that Google and Android have become such mighty brands and used in many parts of the world. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think about this down in the comments? And I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.